Hello guys, welcome again my channel. My name is Layla Joan. Now we start our movie. It's an amazing movie. The movie starts with a battle between two kingdoms. Ying was the name of one of the kingdoms, and Yao was the name of the other. After winning the fight, Ying intends to conquer the entire world. It indicates that they have bad intentions, whereas the people of another kingdom, Yao, were peaceful. That's why they want to bring peace to the world. The Yao kingdom's general's name was Jiang Ying, and defeating him was the most difficult, because a blue dragon used to live in his body, no one could defeat him because of that dragon's power. Actually, the name of blue dragons was Cyan Dragons, which is the name of the film as well. For many generations, the Cyan Dragons have resided in the Lin family. They used the Lin people's bodies as a host. Now, the Cyan Dragon was in the body of Jiang Ying. That's why he was quite powerful, because Jiang Ying Yao kingdom was about to win the war. Before they could fully win the war, the people of the Ying kingdom arrived to fight, armed with special powers. They have turned to the board of Yao kingdom. Because the people of Ying kingdom, those have come to fight, has called a special dragon from underground, who killed the entire army of Yao with a single attack. As they are being defeated, Jiang Ying has called the strength of the Cyan Dragon to defeat them. He quickly killed the underground dragon and pushed him down from the sky using his abilities. The terror of this monster isn't the only thing that the Yao army is afraid of. That Ying's army has many powers alike. They are killing the people of Yao kingdom by using their power. Only Jiang Ying has the ability to fight the Ying army. As a result, he was unable to save his people, and another dragon rose from the ground during this time to battle Jiang Ying, and Jiang Ying has been injured by him. When a soldier from their army sees Jiang Ying injured, he rushes to his help. Because Jiang Ying believes he is about to die, he draws out the dragon's power and gives it to Leo. The man who has come to save Jiang tells Leo that he should take this power and go to the city. And after going there, meet my sister Cyan Dragon. He couldn't understand what to do. Whether he should leave the war on Zhang's instructions or fight to save himself and the others. After Jiang Ying's request, he rides his horse to the location where he must meet Cyan Dragon. The scene cuts and we see Cyan Dragon, who was getting fighting training from some of the people. After watching her, we can see that she, like her brother, has special fighting skills. She is undergoing training so that, like her brother, she may be able to save herself, the Cyan Dragon, and the kingdom. Later, we see Leo has also reached here and he tells Cyan Dragon that General Jiang Ying has sent him. Leo has something that he wants to show Cyan Dragon. Leo has given her the dragon from his body. However, the dragon emerges for a short while before absorbing into Leo's body. Cyan Dragon was shocked when he sees this, because the Lin family has always been trusted by these dragons. Leo, on the other hand, was not from the Lin family. She later brings Leo to a mysterious temple and tells him about the battle. For generations, war has been fought between the kingdoms of Yin and Yao. She says that the Yin kingdom has long desired to occupy this kingdom. The Yao kingdom, on the other hand, is always trying to save this world. That's why Lin's family used to be the king of the Yao family. Cyan Dragon has chosen him by considering him his host for his powers, that he wants to consume his powers through the body of Lin's family. She tells him that the story wasn't ended here. When this power was transferred to my brother after going through everyone, he couldn't handle it well due to the weakness of these powers in the war. Cyan Dragon transformed into a tiny blue dragon. Later, Cyan Dragon holds a stone at the temple and uses it to free the dragon from Leo's body. She becomes surprised to see that the Cyan Dragon wasn't ready to come out. Cyan Dragon was shocked when she saw this. As I previously stated, the Cyan Dragon does not trust anyone except the Lin family. He has been living with the Lin family for a long time, but Cyan Dragon has chosen someone else as their host by leaving Lin's family. Later, after seeing this, Cyan Dragon asks Leo to stay at her house. Later, the scene shifts and we see Si Tu Dang, to the Ying Kingdom's king. There he comes to know that her brother has died. After his death, the dragon has now vanished. On the other hand, we see Liu in Si Tu Dang's house, where he emerges the dragon from his body. They both talk to each other but Liu doesn't understand the dragon. The scene again shifts on Si Tu Dang. King was consulting with others about what they should do to end the battle. Si Tu Dang says, despite my brother's death, the dragon within him has not vanished. It means our powers haven't ended yet, and she informs everyone that dragon has found a new host that was fighting in the same war for Yao Kingdom. After listening to her, everyone laughs, because they believe that only the Lin family is capable of handling Cyan's powers, with the help of their fighting skills. They believe that if the dragon chooses an ordinary man as his host, that man could end the dragon's powers because he couldn't handle Cyan's powers and will ruin things. And everyone will have the danger of this. During their conversation, Si Tu Dang again speaks and tells King that they have to keep on fighting against the Yin Kingdom, because we still have the powers of the dragon. King ignores them all and orders Shan to go to the battlefield. After arriving home, Si Tu Dang informs Liu that we would be fighting at the border once more. Liu requests Si Tu Dang to teach him some skills to control the powers of dragon. Later, we see them crossing the journey of border. On the way, Si Tu Dang has given Liu training on his request. We learn afterwards that they had chosen to spend the night at an abandoned house. Instead of taking a rest, Liu has continued his training. While Liu and Si Tu Dang were resting, at midnight the powerful soldiers of Ying Kingdom has attacked them. They've come to steal the dragon's powers from the Liu. They're all lined up in front of them, ready to fight. Si Tu Dang prevents them from entering, but a man manages to reach Liu in some way. After using all of his powers, he attempts to eliminate all of the dragon's powers within Liu. As Liu doesn't know the control of dragon powers, that's why he was powerless, and the dragon's powers were getting out from him. Before all the powers would emerge out from his body, a companion of Si Tu Dang sacrifices his life, in order to save Liu and the power of his dragon. As a result, Si Tu Dang has won in this conflict. All of her soldiers have died in this war and she was also injured. After a long time, we observe Liu regaining his senses. When he notices the dead troops all around him, he gets shocked. After hearing this, all of his courage disappears as he realizes that they all died to save Liu. Liu requests that Si Tu Dang return home, because he believes he will lose his Cyan Dragon's powers. As a result, they will be unable to fight the Kingdom of Ying, and their kingdom will lose. Si Tu Dang doesn't like his idea. She tells him not to give up because you have extraordinary powers, you just know how to use them properly. She tells him that it doesn't matter if he gives up, it's just that she will never give up, because I know this kingdom has sacrificed many lives to save this kingdom, including my brother. Would you let these sacrifices of dead people go to waste? She asks Liu, those who have given their lives in order to save you and the Cyan Dragon. Si Tu Dang faints from fatigue while saying this. After a while, Liu wraps her wounds with bandages, and we view the scene the next day. There Si Tu Dang was completely recovered. Liu brings some apple for her to eat. Despite having dragon power, she informs Liu that she will not compel him to fight if he does not want to. You are free to return home if you so desire. But she tells him that if you go, I could never go, because I'm the last girl of Lin family, and I have to save Cyan Dragon and this country. Liu was happy that Si Tu Dang hasn't forced him to fight, but was sad that many people have sacrificed their lives for him. Si Tu Dang and Liu went their separate ways the next day. On the journey, Liu has the feeling that he has left Si Tu Dang. He shouldn't do this because she was battling heroically against the Lin Kingdom's people. We have seen the power of Cyan Dragon in her hands. After defeating the soldiers of Kingdom, she has to face a giant creature. Si Tu Dang's abilities were ineffective in front of her. It was difficult for Si Tu Dang to fight. Liu has entered to help Si Tu Dang, but the dragon was strong. With a single attack, he had thorn both of them. C2 Dang awakens later, and the beast transforms into dust as a result of her strike. Transferring in the dust wasn't a sign of his death, rather, the dragon had trapped C2 Dang and was suicided to stab her in the backside. As a result of his death in front of Leo, C2 Dang grew depressed. The dragon's inner powers emerge as a result of his sadness. Later, we witness Leo flying across the sky, and after his departure, a dragon mark is made in the sky. It implies that all of Cyan Dragon's powers have been restored. That was lost by a general in a war. Now Leo with the powers of dragon again comes to the battlefield. After coming down he fights all people of Ying Kingdom and kills them. But the war hasn't ended yet because another dragon comes from underground. This dragon has troubles Leo but he wasn't to give up. He sneaks away and, after grabbing his weapon, attacks the dragon's heart while fleeing. The dragon died as a result of this. The king of Ying Kingdom was the one who was rescued. He was successful in bringing peace to the world after killing him. He decides to take the body of C2 Dang in the city after winning the war. She died on the battlefield during the battle. We should never underestimate somebody, as this film tells us. Everyone thinks Leo to be inferior, and they believe that only the Ying family is capable of controlling the Cyan's dragon powers, because the Ying clan is the most powerful and respected. This movie and the character of Leo tells that the powerful person is one who uses his abilities and fights. As Leo has saved this kingdom after fighting with everyone, the film ends here. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe our channel for more video.